morning, senior high school students. How have you been? I hope you're all doing good. Welcome to your video lesson for your core subject, General Mathematics. Congratulations for having successfully finished weeks 1 to 6 lessons for second quarter. I am your math teacher, Ma'am Desiree O. Galamay, your virtual mentor for today's lesson. Reasoning has been part of your daily conversation. It is where you connect your thoughts and make reasonable conclusions. Now, you're about to learn week 7 of the second quarter of the first semester. It is about the key concepts of propositional logic. Are you excited to learn now? Come on, and let's begin. Before we begin, I want you to prepare the following materials. First, your learning activity sheet for week 7 in general mathematics, your pen, and finally, your paper or notebook. For our learning competencies, you should be able to, number 1, illustrate and symbolize propositions. Number 2, distinguish between simple and compound propositions. Number 3, perform the different types of operations on propositions. Number 4, determine the truth values of propositions. And number 5, illustrate the different forms of conditional propositions. Logic, as a study of reasoning, seeks the rules and principles of how people should reason rationally. When you use your reasoning skills to make a point or share your thoughts and make a conclusion, logic makes you reason correctly. In your English lesson, you have learned the different types of sentences, and these are declarative, interrogative, imperative, and exclamatory sentences. But how is this related to our lesson? I want you to consider the following sentences. First, Tarlac City is in Region 2. Second, General Mathematics is one of the subjects in senior high school. And third, how old are you? The statements that you make in reasoning are called propositions. Let us first define a proposition. A proposition is a declarative sentence that is either true or false, but not both. Let's go back to sentence 1. Tarlac City is in Region 2. Note that this is a declarative sentence which is false. Therefore, this is a proposition. For sentence number 2, General Mathematics is one of the subjects in senior high school. Note that this is also a declarative sentence which is true, and thus, it's also a proposition. Sentence number 3, on the other hand, is neither true nor false since it is an interrogative sentence. Thus, this is not a proposition. Also, remember that a proposition is usually denoted by the lowercase letters P, Q, and R. Now take a look at the following statements and let us determine whether H is a proposition or not. Statement P, Alwin is a grade 11 student. This statement is a declarative sentence whose truth value can be known. Thus, it is a proposition. Statement Q, ouch! The statement is an exclamatory sentence. Thus, it's not a proposition. For statement R, 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. The mathematical sentence can be translated to, the sum of 1 and 2 is 3. Which is a declarative sentence that is true. Thus, it is a proposition. Take note that
Propositions can also be written in symbols like this example. For statement S, it will rain tomorrow. This statement is a declarative sentence. As for its truth value, we shall have to wait until tomorrow. But it will either be true or false, but definitely not both. Thus, it is a proposition. And finally, for statement T, what is a function? The statement is an interrogative sentence. Thus, it is not a proposition. In English, you form compound sentences using conjunctions. In logic, you have compound propositions. Connectives or logical operators are used to make compound propositions.
The different logical operators are shown in the following table. They are read as follows: not, and, or, implies, and if and only if.
Now, let us define a compound proposition. A compound proposition is a proposition formed from simpler propositions using logical connectors or some combination of logical connectors. A proposition is simple if it cannot be broken down any further into other component propositions.
What do you think about the propositions here? The proposition, General Mathematics is one of the subjects in senior high school, is an example of a simple proposition. While the proposition, Math is challenging and interesting, is an example of a compound proposition since it uses the connector AND. Recall that a proposition can either be true or false, but not both. The truth value of a simple proposition is quite easy to determine. But how about for compound propositions? Let us first define what a truth table is. Given a proposition, its truth table shows all its possible truth values. A truth table involving n propositions has 2 raised to n rows. This is used to determine the truth value of a compound proposition based on the truth values of its simple components. The following tables show the truth tables for 1 proposition, 2 propositions, and 3 propositions respectively.
Now, let us study the different compound propositions. We have the negation, conjunction, disjunction, conditional, and biconditional.
The negation of a proposition P is denoted by this symbol and is read as not P. The truth table of the negation of a proposition is defined in the following table. The negation operator is a unary operator. As seen in the truth table, the negation operator changes the truth value of the proposition. When P is true, its negation not P is false. On the other hand, if P is false, its negation not P is true. Say for example, we have the proposition P, 4 is a factor of 8. The negation will be not P, 4 is not a factor of 8. Since 4 is a factor of 8 is true, then its negation is false.
The next compound proposition is the conjunction. The conjunction of propositions P and Q is denoted by this symbol and is read as P and Q. The propositions P and Q are called conjuncts. The truth table of the conjunction of propositions is defined as follows. The conjunction operator is a binary operator which, when applied to 2 propositions as seen in the truth table, is true when both P and Q are true and false otherwise. Aside from the word AND, the words BUT, EVEN THOUGH, YET, and WHILE are also used for conjunctions. For example, if you let T, math is challenging, and Q, math is interesting, the conjunction will be math is challenging and interesting. It can also be math is challenging but interesting. Also, you can use math is challenging yet interesting. Another is, even though math is challenging, it is interesting. You can also use, while math is challenging, it is interesting.
Another compound proposition is the disjunction. The disjunction of propositions P and Q is denoted by this symbol and is read as P or Q. The propositions P and Q are all disjuncts. The truth table of the disjunction of propositions is defined in the following table. The disjunction operator is a binary operator which, when applied to two propositions, as seen in the truth table, is true when either P or Q is true or both P and Q are true. For example, if you let P as Axel is reviewing for his math quiz and Q as Axel is watching TV, then the disjunction P or Q is either Axel is reviewing for his math quiz or is watching TV.
Note that from the truth table, the conditional is only false when the proposition P is true but Q is false. Otherwise, the truth value is always true. Take a look at the conditional. If 2 is even, then 3 is odd. 2 is even and 3 is odd are both true statements. Since both the hypothesis P and conclusion Q are true, then the conditional is true. For the conditional, if 2 is even, then it is not a prime number. 2 is even is true, while 2 is not a prime number is false. Therefore, based on the truth table, a true hypothesis implying a false conclusion is a false conditional.
Finally, we have the biconditional. The biconditional of propositions P and Q is denoted by this symbol, read as P if and only if Q. The proposition may also be written as P if and only if Q. The propositions P and Q are the components of the biconditional. The truth table of the biconditional of propositions is defined as follows. The biconditional is true if P and Q have the same truth value. For the biconditional, 2 is even if and only if it is not prime. Based on the second row of the truth table, with statement P as true and Q as false, this biconditional is false.
Now what if you have more complex compound propositions? The truth table is also helpful to determine the truth values of more complex compound propositions.
Let us study the following complex compound proposition and determine its truth values. P implies Q, implies not P, implies not Q. Since there are two propositions P and Q, there will be 2 raised to 2 equal to 4 rows of possible combinations of truth values of P and Q.
The next thing you have to do is to identify the truth values of the conditional P implies Q, the negations not P and not Q, and the conditional not P implies not Q. This can be seen in the third up to the sixth column of the following table. Finally, identify the truth values of the complex compound proposition P implies Q implies not P implies not Q. You have true, true, false, and true. This is now the complete truth table. Now take a look at some more examples of more complex compound propositions and their truth table. Notice that the last column of the first truth table for the compound proposition Q implies P or Q is consists entirely of true. This shows that the proposition is always true. As for the second table, for the compound proposition P or Q, and not P and not Q, it consists entirely of F, which means that the proposition is always false.
A proposition that is always true is called a tautology, while a proposition that is always false is called a contradiction. A tautology is denoted by tau, and a contradiction by phi. A proposition that is neither a tautology nor a contradiction is a contingency. The proposition Q implies P or Q is a tautology, while the proposition P or Q and not P and not Q is a contradiction. The proposition P implies Q implies not P, implies not Q, in the example earlier, is a contingency. Now, if two propositions have the same truth values for all the possible truth values of their simple components, then the two propositions are said to be logically equivalent. Take a look at the compound propositions P implies Q and Q implies P, and P if and only if Q, with the following truth table. Notice that the last two columns show that the two compound propositions have the same truth values. What does this mean? It means that they are logically equivalent. Another way to show that two propositions are logically equivalent is to show that their biconditional is a tautology, as shown in the given truth table. Notice that the last column of the truth table consists entirely of T, showing that the propositions is always true. Thus, the compound proposition is a tautology. Furthermore, the compound proposition, or P implies Q and Q implies P, and P if and only if Q, is indeed logically equivalent.
Now, we also have different forms of conditional propositions that can be derived from the conditional P implies Q. These are the converse, inverse, and contrapositive. First, we have the converse. Given the propositions P and Q, the converse is written by interchanging the hypothesis and the conclusion of the conditional statement. That is, Q implies P. Consider the conditional, if Dylan's strand is ABM, then he is in the academic track. What do you think is its converse? Its converse is, if Dylan is in the academic track, then his strand is ABM.
Next, we have the inverse. The inverse is written by negating both the hypothesis and the conclusion. That is, not P implies not Q. Using the conditional in the previous example, the inverse will be, if Dylan's strand is not ABM, then he is not in the academic track. Finally, we have the contrapositive. The contrapositive is written by interchanging the negation
of the hypothesis and the conclusion of the conditional statement. That is, not Q implies not P. What do you think will be the contrapositive of the given conditional statement? You're right. It is, if Dylan is not in the academic track, then his strand is not ABM.
Now let us check if you understood our lesson. In your learning activity sheet, there are four activities. What we will do now is we will take the first item of activities 1 and 2 and explain the answer, then you will do the succeeding ones on your own. I always believe that you can do it. For the first activity, you are to complete the table by writing a check mark if the given statement is a proposition and an X mark if otherwise. If the statement is a proposition, you also need to give its truth value by writing T or F. Furthermore, identify the propositions as simple or compound by writing S or P respectively. The given statement in number 1 is Manny Pacquiao is not a Filipino. Is it a proposition or not? Think carefully. Since the statement is a declarative sentence that can either be true or false, then the answer is yes. Now, is it true or false? Also, since the proposition involves a logical connector not, then it is a compound proposition. In case you find it difficult, you can go back to the start of this transcript and review the discussion. Let's now proceed to the next activity. For activity 2, you are given the simple propositions P, Filipinos are hardworking, and Q, Filipinos are punctual. You are to use the simple propositions and construct the specified compound proposition. For the first item, can you construct the negation of statement P? Let's do it! The negation of statement P is Filipinos are not hardworking. That was easy, right? I know you can do the rest of the compound propositions. Finally, for activity 4, conditionals are given and you need to write its converse, inverse, and contrapositive. I wish you all the excellence as you do your best in accomplishing this task. Now, let us see how well you reflect on the lesson you have studied. How can you apply your learnings from this lesson in real life? Write a statement about this using all the different forms of compound propositions. Do not be afraid to answer because there is no wrong answer in this reflective question, okay? Just be yourself as you share your experiences and learnings in this lesson.
All right, senior high school students, we are now done with our discussion. Do you have questions? How do you find the lesson so far? Did you gain new learnings about propositions? Now, if you have unclear ideas, you may go back from the beginning of our video lesson. If everything is fine now, we can start answering the activities. Let's do it! Congratulations! You have successfully finished our lesson for this week. In this lesson, you were able to illustrate and symbolize propositions. You have distinguished between simple and compound propositions. Furthermore, you have learned the different types of operations on propositions and determined their truth values. Lastly, you learned the different types of conditional propositions. By this time, I hope that you can apply whatever lessons you've learned in your daily reasoning and decision making. You can apply the different concepts about proposition to help you make a better decision. Do not forget these learnings, for you can carry them with you as you move forward to the next level. Congratulations for finishing this transcript, and may you continue doing well in the succeeding lessons. I am always proud of you. Again, this is Ma'am Desiree O. Galamay, your virtual teacher in general mathematics. Goodbye and keep safe, everyone.